I'm doing what I've been trying to do ever since I came to this country, find the most beautiful carpet in Persia. Of course, you know that the Persians are very famous for their carpets, and we've seen thousands since we've been here. We've seen them in the tea houses, in the hotels, in the homes, and hanging at the doors of the tents and on the floors. And this is a carpet warehouse where they make them, store them, and sell them. And experts come from all over the world to buy them, and they're considered a very good investment. If I were an expert, I could tell by simply looking at the pattern and colour of a carpet which district it came from. For instance, I've been told that this one is Isfahani. This one is Bakhtiari. And this one is Nain. And I think that one is particularly beautiful. If you look at a carpet closely, you've probably got one on the floor at home, you'll see that it's made up of lots and lots of tufts of wool. Only the difference between your carpet and this carpet is that every single tuft in this carpet is knotted and put in place by hand, as you'll see, because I thought it would be rather fun to find out exactly how a Persian carpet is made. So how does it all start? They make carpets out of wool and silk, and this is a natural skein of wool, the colour it came off the sheep's back, except that of course it's been spun. The first thing is to dye the wool, and the best carpets use natural dyes, vegetables and insects. This is the sort of thing that they use. Dried flowers, nuts. This is pomegranate skin, dried again, makes a rather beautiful yellow colour. And this is the resin that they use to make the dye fast. And all this has to be ground down to a very, very, very fine powder. Here's where it's done, deep down in the heart of the carpet bazaar. This old seed and flour mill is driven by a camel. Luckily for the camel, there aren't many of these left, and they're mostly machine-driven now. The camel master walks behind him, shaking a chain, making encouraging noises to keep him moving. And the camel himself is blindfolded so that he doesn't get dizzy as he goes round and round. When all the seeds, flowers and resin are finally ground down, they're mixed with water, which is brought to the boil in a huge cauldron. The quantity of dye has to be very carefully worked out, and when the colour is just right, in goes the wool, put in by two expert dyers. Very hot and very sticky work. I'm having a lesson in how to stir the pot from Mohammed here. It has to be stirred very evenly to keep all the wool evenly dyed throughout. It stays in here, depending on the quality of the wool or silk, for several hours or several days. And then after that, it's taken out onto the rooftops and into the courtyards outside to dry. And here it stays in the boiling hot Persian sun until it is absolutely dry, and then it goes to the nimble fingers of the carpet weavers. Isn't it incredible? Have you ever seen the fantastic dexterity with fingers? And what's more, I think you'll be surprised when you see how very young the owners of some of those fingers are. Zora, you see? She's only 14. Before today, lots of children much younger used to work in the carpet factories, but recently there's been a law to say that you have to be 14 to work an 8-hour day. But of course Zora and her mates who work here in the factory learnt when they were very young, practicing at home, because they had to learn to be very, very quick before they could actually work on the carpets. Usually with a carpet you have one or two experts who are keeping an eye on the pattern, and young girls like Zora actually work on the background. Zora? You, Heri Zareng. Heri Zareng. That means very clever. Took me a long time to learn that. They always laugh here when they hear my name as well, because Suzanne, it means hot, something which burns you, and so they prefer to call me Sue. You see, the door starts off with a fit of the giggles. So quick. Each row of tiny knots is banged firmly into place with a sort of metal fork with a wooden handle. And then the ends are trimmed flat. Yeah. But let's go back to the beginning.
When they start to make the carpet, they stretch a whole lot of very strong silken threads on a wooden frame. And then they weave the wool design crossways into it. The designs are often taken actually from the mosques, the tile designs in the mosques, and they're put into a pattern which is rather like graph paper, and every one of these squares represents a single knot. So of course, when you actually see it in the carpet, it's much smaller. Look, excuse me, that flower is that flower. Okay. Put that back, and I think I really ought to have a go at knotting, don't you? Can I tuck in here? I need to be slim for this. Right, now I want a lesson. Come on, Zora, show me how. Give me a lesson. Two strands, yes. Left hand and under. Round that one.
Yes.
Through there. Under.
Yes.
Am I that? Huh. Is that all? Under there, round there, whoops, through there, pull down. Ah, but if I had the knife as well, I'd be cutting my fingers off. Round, through, and down. Well, considering it takes me about 15 seconds to do one knot, and a clever carpet weaver can do about 1,000 knots in an hour, I've got a long way to go. Moreover, there are 2,800 knots across every single row of this carpet.